correctly with ease and confidence. Wish you the best of luck and the floor.
Oi. Good afternoon, gentlemen. My name is Roberto Carlos Alberto Carrera, and as you can see, I'm from Brazil. My country is famous out of three things: football, samba, and Amazon River. So football, not this kind of football, I mean real football, as you might know, was invented by the English, but it was us who perfected it. In fact, we fell in love with the game. So in 1950, our government wanted to show the world how good our national team was. So we hosted the FIFA World Cup. Our national team, who used to wear all white outfit, was killing every opponent by winning with 2, 5, and even 7 goals. Until we reached the final match against the former champion, Uruguay, which, based on our results, nobody had a doubt that we would easily win the cup. Like nobody has a doubt that Al Hilal would win the Asian Cup against Sydney. And Aurora. But anyway, on the day of the match, Brazilians from all over the country flooded Rio de Janeiro City to celebrate the expected win, filling the stadium with 250,000 supporters, exceeding its capacity. The match began, and it was enough for our team to either win or a draw was fine, since we had enough points. But before the end of the game, the result was 1-1. It was okay up to this point. But unfortunately, Uruguay striker noticed that the goalkeeper was not in his position. So he took that chance and boom! Scored the second goal. Silence filled the stadium until the final whistle was blown, allowing everybody to start crying. It was disaster, as described by the local newspaper. And the real disaster is what happened to the goalkeeper after this match. He was harassed, beaten, forbidden from his position. Not only him, but all people with black skin were considered jinxed and forbidden. After this match, our national team was obliterated. We did not win a single match after this for 7 years. And because of this, even the white t-shirt was hated and considered cursed. And if you ask why all this drama, simply because we Brazilians are superstitious. So before the next World Cup term, our government announced for a public competition to design a national team outfit. And the only rule was that it should replace the Brazilian flag. Vast green Amazonian field, yellow color reflects its natural resources of gold, vast blue skies full of white. 401 design was, but only one design was accepted. This design was one of many submitted by Garcia, a local newspaper reporter living in a small village at the border of Uruguay. This design was tested in a friendly match and proved successful. And everybody was optimistic that the curse was gone with this new t-shirt. And this guy was considered a national hero. So here comes the next FIFA World Cup in Sweden. Our team was doing so good with the new t-shirt until we reached the final match against the host, Sweden. And because the Swedish national team outfit was yellow, we were asked to change our own. Our players refused to wear the old cursed t-shirt. Therefore, we sent our representative to Stockholm market and bought 22 blue outfits. The match began. Our players were doing so amazing. Everyone was impressed by the way we played, which can only be described as passion. first time in history, we won the World Cup. Woo-hoo!
Yes.
This is holistic, unbroken, sunny outfit is not only the national outfit of the Brazil. It's a source of happiness that reflects everybody's love to the game. This design reminds us that even if you consider yourself as a small, unimportant person, believe me when I say that you, yes, you, have the key to bring joy to everyone around you. These designs remind us that change is good, but it should always reflect your true identity. It doesn't have to be complex, because simplicity is elegant. And let me tell you this. Football is life. Sometimes you're up, sometimes you're down. But remember that every time you hit rock bottom, you will rise up to